Let's come to topic number three, occlusive trauma and excessive occlusive forces. And the background paper was developed by Jin Fan and Jack Caton. And they in fact scrutinized all the available literature on this difficult topic that has been out there for many, many years. And the critical questions we faced were these. Does traumatic occlusive force, occlusive trauma, cause periodontal attachment loss in humans? And can traumatic occlusive forces cause non-carious cervical lesions? And these are the answers we came up with. Well, there's no evidence that traumatic occlusive force or occlusive trauma causes periodontal attachment loss in humans. And this is in contrast to some of experimental animal findings, but this is the most relevant outcome, and that's why we emphasized that these were the findings in humans. Can traumatic occlusive forces cause non-carious cervical lesions? Well, there's no credible evidence that traumatic occlusive forces cause non-carious cervical lesions. We also came up with case definitions and diagnostic considerations. Traumatic occlusive force is defined as any occlusive force resulting in injury of the teeth and or the periodontal attachment apparatus. So this new term, traumatic occlusive force, replaces the historically defined term excessive force to indicate that the forces involved exceed the adaptive capacity of the individual person or site. The presence of such a traumatic occlusive force may be indicated by one or more of the following: frematus, tooth mobility, thermal sensitivity, excessive occlusive wear, tooth migration, discomfort, pain on chewing, fractured teeth, radiographically widened periodontal ligament space, root resorption, and hypercementosis. So careful differential diagnosis has to be made. And secondly, the term occlusive trauma. That is a lesion in the periodontal ligament, cementum, and adjacent bone caused by traumatic occlusive forces. It's a histological term. However, a clinic diagnosis of occlusive trauma may be made in the presence of one or more of the following. And this would be progressive tooth mobility, adaptive tooth mobility, also called frematus, radiographically widened periodontal ligament space, tooth migration, discomfort, pain on chewing, and root resorption. Again, a careful differential diagnosis has to be made here.